Hello, fellow classmates and esteemed teacher. This is our National History Day project on the legacy and leadership of Elizabeth Blackwell. This project was compiled by Vahe Yakubian, Alike Premian, Selim Vorosyan, and Noel Andonian. Thank you so much, Mr. Kevin Wang, for assigning this life-changing project. It has revolutionized our outlook on female leadership.
If society will not admit of women's free development, then society must be remodeled. Elizabeth Blackwell.
Hello, my name is Vahe Yakubian, and I am going to be talking about the life of Elizabeth Blackwell. Elizabeth Blackwell was born on February 3, 1821 in Bristol, England. At the age of 11, she and her family moved to the United States, specifically in Cincinnati, Ohio. Elizabeth Blackwell's mother was able to open up a school for her and her sisters in order to receive an education. However, while she was receiving an education in her family-built school, her father died in 1838, while Elizabeth Blackwell was just a teenager. Elizabeth Blackwell decided that she wanted to pursue a career in medicine and become a doctor. She studied independently with a doctor before getting accepted to the Geneva Medical College in New York in 1847. This had been her first acceptance after getting rejected from 29 different medical schools. However, being a female medical student was not easy. She faced public criticism from not only her peers, but also from the general public. Despite these challenges, she was able to gain the respect of her fellow peers, and in 1849, she was finally able to graduate medical school. After graduating medical school, she became a naturalized U.S. citizen. In order to expand her medical knowledge, she decided to travel to Europe, where she would receive education in Paris and in London. In Paris, she worked at the maternity hospital, where unfortunately she suffered from an eye infection and lost sight in that eye. Shortly afterwards, she worked at St. Bartholomew's Hospital in London, where she and Florence Nightingale became friends. She then returned to America in 1851, where she opened up her private practice in New York. However, with men controlling the budgets in most families, she had few patients and earned most of her income lecturing on hygiene. In 1853, she opened up a clinic that became known as the New York Dispensary for Poor Women and Children. With the help from her sister and fellow doctor, Emily Blackwell, she established the New York Infirmary for Indigent Women and Children in 1857. That same year, she became the first woman listed on the British Medical Register. In the late 1860s, Blackwell created a medical school for women. One of her students, Jophia Jex Blake, would later open a medical school for women in London. Elizabeth Blackwell helped establish the U.S. Sanitary Commission, which became active in 1861. Shortly after helping establish the U.S. Sanitary Commission, she returns to England, where she set up a private practice in London and served as another lecturer at the London School of Medicine for Women. Elizabeth Blackwell retired in 1877 and moved to Hastings. Elizabeth Blackwell died at her home on May 31st, 1910. Elizabeth Blackwell had lived an amazing life. Her achievements were amazing, and it was quite a feat for a woman at that time to accomplish. However, her legacy, which can be seen today, is quite astounding.
Blackwell's accomplishments. In 1852, Elizabeth Blackwell published her book called The Laws of Life with special reference to the physical education of girls, which was a collection of lectures she wrote on health. Next, she founded and opened a dispensary, which is a room where medicines are prepared and provided, basically like a pharmacy, in New York City with two other new female physicians named Dr. Mary E. Zerkweski and Elizabeth's younger sister, Dr. Emily Blackwell, whom she worked very closely with. Eventually, the dispensary became incorporated and was transformed into the New York Infirmary for Women and Children. Elizabeth returned to England to encourage other women to enter the field of medicine so that female leadership as doctors, nurses, or any other medical positions will become more common, popular, accepted, and well-known throughout the world. In 1859, she was admitted to the Medical Register of the United Kingdom. Dr. Blackwell was the first woman to ever receive that honor. Elizabeth and Emily Blackwell inspired, organized, and worked with the Women's Central Association of Relief and the United States Sanitary Commission extensively for several years. Next, the two sisters opened the Women's Medical Center, where Elizabeth was appointed the position of Chair of Hygiene. In England, Elizabeth helped form the National Health Society and the London School of Medicine for Women. Finally, Dr. Blackwell was appointed Professor of Gynecology at the London School of Medicine for Children. She worked there until she retired 32 years later.
The legacy of Elizabeth Blackwell. As the first female doctor, Elizabeth Blackwell left behind a legacy that still lives today. She changed the general idea of women from the point of view of men and society, in not only the medical field, but in the workforce as a whole. She proved that women are just as capable of doing many things that men are known to do. Elizabeth Blackwell is the motivation and inspiration for many women today, young and old, because she went against all odds and did what she knew she could do, which was becoming a doctor despite her gender. She is not only a role model to women in the medical field, but in any working environment where women are seen as inferior because of their gender. After being denied so many times, she still continued to apply to medical schools. She was finally accepted to Geneva Medical School, where the male students thought it would be funny to see a woman trying to obtain a medical degree. Even after she was accepted, she was looked at as inferior. However, she gained the respect of everybody who looked down on her when she graduated and began professionally practicing medicine.
The idea of this project is to present a historic figure in American history that represents leadership and legacy, and those two words are what describe Elizabeth Blackwell. She represents leadership because she, in a time that was impossible or unheard of for a woman to get an education, let alone a medical degree, she took it upon herself to challenge the mentality people had within society to attain a higher education, not only for herself, but to open doors and create new opportunities for other women. She knew that when she took this goal upon herself, it was going to be a challenge because many people were going to reject her due to her female gender. But she proved people wrong, leaving the legacy aspect of this project. She not only achieved her success and goal, but she achieved it with a medical condition, which shows the strength and determination she had. But she also achieved that success while allowing other people to achieve it as well. She opened plenty of doors for women, leaving her mark and inspiration on them that they too can achieve that success. She allowed women to be part of the Civil War by founding and creating the Women's Central Association of Relief. This project became the cornerstone of the United States Sanitary Commission, the federal agency that oversaw nurse training, coordinated volunteer efforts, and provided battlefront hospital and kitchen services. She opened schools and gave them educational foundations to begin achieving their success. Overall, Elizabeth Blackwell was the reason women are as equal, strong, and successful in our society as they are today. She took on the leadership and left the legacy.